Hello, I'm one of NASA Kennedy's launch directors, Charlie Blackwell Thompson, and I'm taking you inside KSC. The first major integrated operation at Launch Pad 39B began this week with the initial tanking of a cryogenic fuel, liquid oxygen, into a giant sphere at the northwest corner of the pad. This operation will help the center prepare for the launch of NASA's Orion spacecraft atop the Space Launch System rocket on its first uncrewed test flight. Several Praxair trucks arrived and offloaded their liquid oxygen, or LO2, slowly, one at a time into the cryogenic sphere to chill it down from normal temperatures to about negative 298 degrees Fahrenheit. Another wave of trucks arrived and offloaded their LO2 all at the same time. During the next several months, trucks will continue to arrive and offload LO2 into the sphere that can hold about 900,000 gallons of liquid oxygen. Upgrades and construction continue as Kennedy Space Center completes the transition to a multi-user spaceport. As the new central campus takes shape in the industrial area, older facilities such as the Central Instrumentation Facility, or CIF, are being demolished. Construction of the CIF began in 1964. The facility provided support to the Apollo and Space Shuttle programs. It was the hub of instrumentation and data processing operations until a modern energy-efficient data center was opened in 2015 to replace it. And remember, Spaceport Magazine digs deeper inside KSC.